Question is from Julie Cassandra. How do you alter your diet or training versus... How do you alter your diet on training versus non-training days?
I love this. And
yeah, I feel like we're going to have a discussion around this because I think you and I are a little different.
Yeah, well, I really love to manipulate this. Like so, and I do this all the time with weekends especially. I've tracked my movement, my activity, my workouts so consistently for so long that I've really got a pretty good idea. So even though I'm not tracking right now, I have a good idea of like what a Saturday looks like or what a good Saturday looks like, what a bad Saturday looks like. And what I mean by good and bad is by my activity level. Like, was I very active that day? Did I train like I need to in order to get my movement and my calorie burn up on a Saturday or Sunday in comparison to like a Monday where I'm starting my day really early and I'm moving a lot and I normally get my workouts always. So I like to adjust my calories that way. I mean, we already talk about the benefits of undulating calories anyways and not having like this, you know, linear calorie intake where it's just like you always, you know, your diet says you eat 1,300 or 1,500 calories or whatever. And so every day you do that. Mm-hmm. I just like to break it up. Like I think, and it makes the most sense to eat less food on the days when I feel like I need the less food because I'm not moving. I'm not pushing the body. It's an off day of working out. So that's what I'll do on my training days. I make sure I'm fed. I make sure that I'm taking care of my body. If I'm going to push up on calories a little bit, I just had this the other night with Katrina. We were talking, this was like 2 nights ago. And, you know, I knew I needed to get at least another like 2 meals in, and it was already like 6 o'clock because I was just behind on calories. And I had a really good hard training session. And yes, I could not eat and get benefits of burning more calories, but I'm trying to build at the moment, and I want to make sure that I reap the benefits of a hard training session like that, so I want to be fed. Now, if I hadn't trained that day and I'm still behind calories, and I would actually not worry about it. I would probably skip a meal and be low calorie that day because the need for the extra calories is less important when I haven't sent a signal to build muscle. If I just sent a loud signal to build muscle, that, in my opinion, is the one of the best times to make sure that I'm getting adequate calories and protein versus a day where I don't train at all. A day like that, I might skip a meal.
Yeah, see, this is where I think you and I are different. By the way, I don't think there's a wrong answer here. So so the way Adam's doing it, perfectly fine. If that's your preference, I think that's a great strategy, and a lot of what you said makes perfect sense. Now, for me, it's actually, believe it or not, it's a little bit of the reverse. On my workout days, I prefer to eat a little bit less. I like to have a lighter feel. I like to, I'm a little busier typically on the days that I work out, so I don't feel like I want to eat as much. On the days off, I like to eat a little bit more. I feel like it helps me recover on the days in between. And here's the other thing that I've, and this is my own theory, but when you're sedentary, you're sending an atrophy signal to your muscle, even if you worked out the day before. So, and again, you can test this yourself. You can work out super hard today and then stay in bed for 2 days and see that you actually end up losing muscle, even though you worked out really hard, you know, the day before. And I used to do this as a kid. I used to think sitting around would help me recover faster. Later on, I realized I actually got to move because I have to continue to send that muscle building signal. Now, one way to offset that, and this is, again, my theory, is to keep the calories high and keep the protein high. High calories, high protein by themselves, not always, okay? And this is not a great strategy all the time, but in combination with exercise, I think it works great. When your calories are high and your protein's high, by itself, independent of workout and anything else, it does send a anabolic signal. In fact, if you take the average person, don't change anything about their lifestyle at all, and just bump their calories into protein, you'll see a tiny bit of muscle mass gain and strength gain. Now it's limited. You're not going to gain tons of muscle. You end up gaining more fat if you stay on that path. But there is a bit of a boosting effect. So when I'm sedentary, eating more, it feels to me like I am able to send more of that signal.
So I would do this also when I was competing and I was really consistent. And I too don't. I like this strategy. I don't coach this way though because I know the average person doesn't have the same self-discipline as I do. And what I've noticed with clients is that if I give them the okay to feed more when they're sedentary.
Oh, they just have more access to food.
Right. Yeah. They tend to make worse choices.
Great point.
And so I agree with everything you're saying. And I, too, will manipulate and play around with my food like that, too. And I think it's great to go both ways if you have the control and discipline to do both. But behaviorally speaking, I notice that clients, that if I tell them on Saturday that they can have a surplus of calories, they have a harder time controlling it versus telling them, hey, you're not moving near as much, so we don't need to feed as much, so this is a day we actually need to reduce. And so I'm telling them to reduce, knowing too that they still might kind of overeat a little bit, so I tend to,
you're
push
right.
that direction.
You're 100% right, because connecting my activity today to my food intake today is a great strategy to help people monitor their food intake. Plus, when you're sedentary and you're sitting around, you're oftentimes sitting around snack food.
Yes.
Sitting around, not doing much.
Watching TV.
Watching TV. Yeah. Mindless eating starts to happen.
It's more cravings at that point.
Absolutely.
That's why, for me personally, like I definitely tend to not eat as much if I'm sedentary, just because it's just, I've conditioned myself to not seek it out as much, because it was always craving type foods that I tended to want to gravitate towards with that, mentality. So, but yeah, I do like going into workouts, not with a lot of calories. Like I like to go into the workout, but then replenishing, after the workout, I tend to eat quite a bit.
So. Yeah. So for those of you who have the discipline to do this, I love to feed myself a lot on the days before I have hard workouts, when I'm more sedentary. So I do that. Then when I go into my workout, I have less food, but I did eat the day before, right? And I have great workouts. I typically get good pumps and I'm really strong. So I used to always prepare for my workout with my food intake the day before rather than the day of, because I like the excess calories, the carbs, but I don't like the feeling like I just ate. So I like to go in with the slightly fasted feeling, but also have the energy from the day before.